In this lesson, you will learn the basics of creating websites with Bootstrap Studio. To begin, you can click the New Design button on the Start screen or this button in the title bar. This opens the New Design dialog. Here you can give your design a name, choose the Bootstrap Framework version, and select one of the templates. We will start with a blank template in this example. For the framework, you can choose between Bootstrap 3, 4, and 5. We will go with version 5. The Bootstrap framework is an open-source collection of CSS and HTML building blocks for creating responsive websites. Bootstrap Studio uses this framework to assemble your designs. After you become familiar with how things are done in Bootstrap Studio, you may wish to learn more about the Bootstrap framework to bring your skills to the next level. But for now, you can let the app handle everything. Press the button and a blank new design is created. The first thing we need to do is to open the View Options menu in the toolbar and activate the Show Box Model setting. This will visualize margins and paddings in the canvas, which will come handy later in the lesson. To construct pages in Bootstrap Studio, you pick components from the component panel and drop them on the canvas. You can see all components here, organized in groups. Since you are just starting out, we will pick something from the UI group. This group gives you large, pre-made building blocks that combine multiple components. When you hover with your mouse, Bootstrap Studio highlights the component you are over. You can click to select. This gives the component a blue outline. You can grab the component here and place it somewhere else on the page. The overview panel shows the structure of your design and highlights the selected component in blue. You can also drag and drop components here. Right-clicking gives you a context menu with actions like editing, copy-paste, deleting, and more. You can even change components from one type to another. You get a great deal of control over where components can be placed. If you grab a small component like an icon, you can place it between the letters of textual components. Double-clicking opens the icon dialog, where you get thousands of icons to choose from. When a component is selected, you can see the focus bar with a few quick actions. This arrow lets you select the parent components. In our case, this is a column and a row. You can see them in the overview. The pencil is for editing the element text. Click it to start editing. You have the standard text formatting operations, and you can also clear all formatting from this button. You can either apply or discard the edit from here. The next action resizes margins and paddings. Click to activate it and grab one of the handles. The orange handles change the margin and green the paddings. I will give the element a background color so it's easier to see what's happening. You drag the margin handle outward. Margins are white space that is drawn outside the element. You can see that this leaves blank space underneath the element, but it remains the same size. On the other hand, if I resize the padding, this will enlarge it. When hovering, the app shows margins and paddings as orange and green highlights, respectively. This can give you a clue on where white space is coming from. By holding the Shift key, you can resize the opposing sides at the same time. By holding both Control and Shift, you can resize all directions at once. We will come back to margin and padding resizing when we explain responsive web design in our next lessons. The next action in the focus bar is component duplication. Next to it, we have the hide action. This hides the component from the page, but it still remains in your design. You can see the extra paragraphs with a hidden icon next to them. Right-click them to show them again. Last is the delete action. When a component is selected, you can change its options from the sidebar. We will leave the appearance panel for a dedicated video and instead switch to the options tab. Here you can find many settings for modifying the component. These options are defined by the Bootstrap framework and will look familiar to you if you've used it in the past. We won't be covering these today, but here is a productivity tip. When you adjust the options, you can copy the entire group and paste it on another component. To reset a group, click here. A feature that many of you will appreciate is multi-selections. Just hold the Command key on Mac or Control on Windows and Linux. With multiple components selected, you can change their options simultaneously. If you make a mistake, keep in mind that Bootstrap Studio has a full undo and redo history. At any time, you can press one of these buttons to undo or redo a step. You can also do multi-step jumps by clicking an entry in the menu. And finally, if you're happy with your design, remember to save. All Bootstrap Studio designs are saved as files with the BS Design extension on your computer. Just choose a folder and give your file a name. If your computer crashes before you save, or you wish to go back to an earlier version of your design, you can open the backup dialog in the file menu. The app takes snapshots of your design every 5 minutes, and you can restore them as a new design in a second tab. Keep in mind that these backups are only retained for 1 week by default. You can change this and other settings from the backup section of the settings dialog. Here you can change the frequency and number of backups, and even set backups to be kept forever. Thank you for watching our basic editing lesson. Check out our next video to learn more about Bootstrap Studio.